This is a free download from the BBC. For more information, go to bbc.co.uk/podcasts. Across beds, hearts and bucks.
This is Iain Lee.
BBC Three Counties Radio.
Well, maybe Paul can do the introduction to the podcast this week.
It was a delicious Christmas breakfast in one of the more upmarket, salubrious cafes in Luton. I'm here with the breakfast team from the BBC Three Counties Radio Iain Lee show.
Just set the scene.
Right, sorry. Three, two. That was a delicious breakfast in one of Luton's more salubrious establishments, and just around the table. Well, I am saying, this is me setting the scene.
Okay, but then introduce, when you say set the scene, you mean introduce the podcast.
Okay.
Hello, you're listening to the Iain Lee podcast.
Hello, you're listening to the Iain Lee podcast, which you've probably downloaded from the internet.
Where else are they going to have downloaded it from?
I don't know, these days, things...
ridiculous... Just get into it. This is the Christmas special.
This is the Christmas special Iain Lee podcast.
Iain Lee Christmas special podcast. We've been through this.
This is the Iain Lee Christmas special podcast. You're joining us in one of Luton's more salubrious cafes.
No,
I'm just starting from scratch, so you've got a start point, okay? Introducing the podcast this week, I would like to start with this wonderful piece of audio from the show. What?
Milton Keynes' Winter Wonderland. The organiser is apparently going to be on Jonathan's show after 9 o'clock. Here's an email from Emma. Heard you're discussing Winter Wonderland at Milton Keynes. It was awful. Luckily, my children are too young, 7 months and 3 years, to really understand. But myself and hubby were very disappointed. Went to Hyde Park last year, didn't expect anything that grand, but didn't expect one carousel having to be pushed around by hand, which they charged £2 for, and the other to have feather dusters as decorations. It was literally a few fairground rides and food stalls in a muddy field. Not really a wonderland. The helium balloons... Oh, no. The helium balloons on one stall were all dragging on the floor and they were trying to sell them for £5 each. When asked why they weren't floating, they were told because they were too big. Honestly, the whole thing was a shame. Only thing there was plenty of portaloos. A complete disgrace. Pleased it's closed. Just disappointed and saddened for all the kids who were looking forward to it. Well, 08459 455 555 is the telephone number if you went there. Just how bad was it? Joined now by Stephen Gordon Wilson from Destination MK, which promotes the town and is an events producer. Morning, Steve.
Morning, Iain.
This isn't great, is it? Milton Keynes is in all the papers, it's on the telly, it's on lots of radio stations, all for the wrong reason.
Tell me about it. I can't really even begin to talk about how angry I am about this. It's absolutely outrageous. I'm angry for the poor children and families. I'm listening to the lady earlier on whose daughter was supposed to be cutting the cake. I was nearly in tears. It's just shocking. I'm angry for the people at the Council and the Parks Trust on their behalf. You know, they were sold this dream of a winter wonderland and it turned up to be a dirty old porter cabin and a bit of something. Personally, as you say, I work on events. I'm angry personally. This guy claims to have spent months and months in the planning.
Oh, he's been planning it since February.
Exactly.
Here.
And to develop that since February is absolutely outrageous. And I know there are a lot of people out there at the moment saying, oh, let's pull together and try and produce something. And that's fantastic. But you can't pull something together like that in a week, unfortunately. And I mean, he obviously couldn't do it in 10 months. I'm really interested to see what he says to JVS this morning.
Well, apparently he's on his way in, which is fantastic. I didn't believe he would come in, but we've been told he is on his way in. It's embarrassing for Milton Keynes. Milton Keynes is a bit of a laughing stock this morning because of this, isn't it?
You're absolutely right. I mean, and that's really the thing I'm the most angry about. I mean, obviously, Destination Milton Keynes and lots of other groups work endlessly to promote the city and to try and make shout good news stories and to build a good Christmas, which so many people have been doing this year. And then in one fell swoop, all of that hard work gets undone by one guy that hasn't put the effort in, hasn't put the time in. And you know, I'm trying to be objective and I'm trying to find some kind of sympathy for him because he says he's a family man and he's been working hard. But I'm sorry, you can't mess around with Christmas like that, especially in somewhere like Milton Keynes, where the standard is really high and everyone works exceptionally hard. He's come in and just knocked it out of the park with one event.
We've got some people saying, and here's an example from Steve. If people saying Christmas is ruined by this man cocking up a simple event, then I feel very sad. Kids don't need an event such as this to make Christmas special. Absolutely true. But having a four-year-old, having a two-year-old, I know that they build these... If you say, right, on Saturday we're going to go to Winter Wonderland and we're going to meet Father Christmas, kids build that thing up in their head. It's heartbreaking, isn't it?
It's desperately sad. I've got a little girl who's nearly four. If I'd have taken her, I don't think I'd have been able to control my anger just on the phone, to be honest. I'm lucky that I didn't take her. I'm desperately angry and sad at these poor people, and especially for the businesses and the charities. You know, listening to the lollipop girls earlier on, that's a heartbreaking story. And the poor Papworth Trust, who were relying on that for funds, all of a sudden have had it snatched away.
Well, they've spent $7,000 on this as well. They've lost money.
Outrageous. And I mean, it's not just the charities. It's the businesses as well. I know that the fairground operator, Stantley, is about $20,000 because they were bought in and there was no one there to use the rides.
Lorenzo, the organiser, is going to be on the show after with JVS. After 9 o'clock, he's going to talk about how he's going to refund the money. Is it practical to refund all the money?
Well, I've heard him speak elsewhere, and he said that he doesn't know how many tickets he's sold. He doesn't know how much money he's made. They were selling tickets on PayPal, for heaven's sake, which isn't a particularly professional way of selling tickets, I suppose. And JVS will know better if actually there's some protection there and people can get their money back off their own back in that way.
Steve, what good things are coming up in Milton Keynes? What have we got to look forward to?
Well, in the distance, you've got the Rugby World Cup and you've got some great events like that. Now, at the moment, there's still plenty going on for Christmas. You know, a lot of people around Milton Keynes, Escape, Frosts, Gullivers have all got some fantastic Christmas events going on. Next year, all sorts of great events coming up. And people work tirelessly in this place to put fantastic events on, and we will pick ourselves back up again.
Yeah.
Milton Keynes don't sit moping for too long. So a huge list of events coming up. Keep an eye on the website and stuff.
Stephen, it's good to talk to you. I'm sorry it's for such a disappointing, embarrassing story. The Winter Wonderland. Did you go? Laura Forsyth is on the line. Good morning, Laura.
Hello.
Now, Laura, tell me what your connection with the Winterland was.
Well, I teach for Tuchel School of Dance in Milton Keynes, and I had a group of 55 dancers aged 6 to 16 who were going to be performing every day at Winter Wonderland. So we've been rehearsing for the whole term, extra classes, parents have paid for costumes, and children were so excited, and now we've got nowhere to perform. They're absolutely devastated. They've put a lot of time and effort into it.
How old are the kids?
The youngest is 6, from 6 up to 16, mixed boys and girls.
And so they are also, and they're going to be dancing there for the whole week?
Yeah, we were supposed to start there yesterday, and they were going to dance every day after school at 6 o'clock, and then following Saturday and Sunday as well.
They must be so gutted.
Yeah, they are. And we've got all these parents paid for costumes and rehearsing. We've got all these lovely Christmas dances and we've got nowhere to perform now. It's so sad. And if there's anybody out there that would like us to come and perform some Christmas numbers somewhere, it'd be really great.
Oh, I'm tempted to invite you to come in and perform in here, but there's not room for all of you. So give us the name of the school again, Laura.
It's Tuchel School of Dance.
Tuchel School of Dance. Look, if there's anybody, it's a long shot, but if there is anybody...
If there's anybody out there, like MK Council, like get us to perform in the shopping centre or something, kids would absolutely love it.
Right, OK. What we're going to do... Catherine, can we put Laura in touch with Steve from Milton Keynes Council we just spoke to, from Destination MK, and see if he can squeeze Laura in somewhere? She'll even perform in the shopping centre. Someone... what music are they dancing to?
There's about 7 numbers. We've got Mariah Carey or Lawrence for Christmas Is You. That's for the little tiny children. And then I've got a middle group that's got like a Christmas medley, like rocking around the Christmas tree. Then I've got an older girl doing a ballet number on point to White Christmas.
If anybody can help, this sounds awesome. If anybody can help, 08459 455555. Or email me, ian.lee@bbc.co.uk. Hang on. Have we got somebody? Is this connected with this or is this... No, hang on a second. What we'll do is we'll also get you in touch with Stephen Gordon-Wilson from Destination MK, the chap we just spoke to. He may not be able to help, Laura, if anyone can, Stephen's the man. Stay on the line. I'll put you back through to either Kelly or Catherine and we'll get you in touch with Stephen, OK?
Thank you
very much. If anybody can help, Laura... 08459 455555. Can we put her through to Stephen? Can we give them swap numbers and see if... Stephen Gordon-Wilson from Destination MK. If anybody can find a home for that show. I'm sure it's him. Things are happening here. We just heard from Laura, who has got all these kids from 6 to 16 that have learned to dance, learned loads of different dances, especially for the Winter Wonderland. Now, Winter Wonderland's been cancelled. Laura has had to break the news to all these kids. I'm really sorry. You've put in all this work. You had a gig and it's been cancelled. I'm really sorry. How heartbreaking is that? How heartbreaking is that? Laura's back on the line. Good morning, Laura.
Hello.
Hello. Well, listen, I said we'd try and sort something out. We've not been able to, I'm afraid.
Oh, OK. Don't worry.
But Stephen Gordon-Wilson from Destination MK might be able to. Stephen?
Hello.
Can you help Laura at all? It's a terrible situation.
It's a horrible situation, and it just makes me more and more sad. But I've spoken to the guys at Escape, and Laura, if you want to come over and get the team there, we can get you on the stage there, as it were.
Oh, that would be amazing. Thank you so much.
The kids
will be so happy.
And the real Santa's there as well. The actual real Santa.
You've got the real Santa, Stephen?
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
That will make me so happy. Thank you so much.
No problem.
Stephen, you're like a little Father Christmas yourself. That's what. Listen to her. She's squeaking. You made Laura squeak. Stephen, I really appreciate that. That is fantastic news, and I didn't want to put you on the spot, but I appreciate your help on this.
No worries.
Laura, is that good news?
That's amazing news. Thank you so much.
Well, there you go.
Thank you.
It took 2 minutes to sort out. He's a good guy. Laura, we'll make sure you swap details. We'll get that all sorted. And let us know when it's happening, and we'll give you a big plug on the show. There you go. Oh, I've gone all tingly. Now I see why Noel Edmonds did it for so many years. Shirley's in Milton Keynes. Good morning, Shirley.
Good morning, Iain.
Shirley, what can I do for you on this wonderful, wonderful Christmas morn? Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas to you too.
And it is Merry Christmas, not Happy Christmas, isn't it?
Well, some say Happy.
People that say Happy are wrong, and it really winds me up. It's Merry Christmas, it's Happy New Year. We get Merry at Christmas,
that's true.
We're Happy... Yeah, exactly.
That's true.
Apology accepted.
Yes. My snowman, light-up snowman that's in the window says Merry Christmas.
Of course he does, because he's a snowman, and snowmen know the correct thing to say. Snowmen wouldn't say Happy Christmas. That's insane.
Yes.
Insania. Shirley, what can... Yes. Oh, Shirley, hang on a second. Hang on. Stand up and salute. Stand up and salute.
Right.
So are you standing up and saluting?
I am.
And then do a curtsy.
Yes, I've done that.
And then do a cartwheel.
Oh, yeah, you'll be lucky.
Yes. Here we go, ladies and gentlemen. It's, oh, no, hang on a second. He's only the ambassador. It's not the... I thought it was the king.
I thought it was a king.
Flipping it. Colin, I do apologise. I thought you were the king, Colin.
That's all right.
He's only the... he's the ambassador of Dunstable. I feel a bit silly now. We've broken the etiquette rules, Shirley.
Oh, dear. Never mind.
Never mind. Who wants to go first?
Well, I don't mind.
Ladies first.
Right. I got a feeling that programme was called Rip Off Britain.
You're talking about Hangdog, yes? You think Hangdog was called Rip Off Britain?
The Gloria Honeyford programme, I think, was Rip Off Britain.
Is she right, Colin, the ambassador of Dunstable?
I do believe so.
Here's an interesting fact about Gloria Honeyford. Yes. I worked with her about a year ago on This Morning, and it was like her 70th birthday or something. And do you know what she was going to buy herself as a birthday present?
No.
A tattoo.
Oh, you're joking.
She was going to get a tattoo, I think, of a fairy or an angel on her ankle.
Oh.
Dirty.
Oh, dear.
Isn't that awful?
At that age, yes.
Isn't it?
I mean, she's such an elegant woman, though, but, oh, dear. No.
not elegant getting a tattoo done.
Oh, I don't like tattoos, full stop.
Oh, no.
I don't either.
Have you gone off her now, Colin?
Who? Gloria?
Yes.
No, I've never really been on her.
Would you like to?
No.
Shirley, let's moving swiftly on. Shirley, have you gone off her?
No, I haven't. I think she's a lovely lady.
Do you want to see more older women on TV?
Yeah, why not? Why not? Why should we be discriminated against?
That's right, yes.
Just because we're older, I mean, I'm in my 70th year now, but just because we're older, why should we be discriminated against?
Absolutely.
But saying that, Brucey's too old, isn't he?
No, he's not. I like Brucey.
Oh, he's rubbish now.
I like Brucey. Some of his jokes are a bit silly.
Yes.
But I do like Brucey. I think he's wonderful. He's so agile.
Well, hardly. You can hardly move.
Well, I don't know.
Colin, have you ever been on Brucey?
No.
Would you like to?
No. Never really liked him.
No. OK, well, thank you very much indeed. That's Colin in Dunstable, Shirley in Milton Keynes.
You kind of interrupted my breakfast, guys. This week I went to see a psychic. I was going through a bit of a crossroads in my life. So I went to see Gary. It was in a dark room.
You never told us he was called Gary!
He was called Gary!
Psychic Gary!
Yeah, I went to see Gary and... the guys on the show thought it was interesting and decided to talk about it.
Joyce is in Leegrave. Morning, Joyce.
Hello.
Good morning, Joyce.
Good morning. Sorry, I had to run and put the radio off.
Good for you. Well done. No, don't run. Just take a gentle stroll.
Oh, no, that's not my scene.
Are you... Not your scene, man. Are you looking forward to Christmas, you old hipster?
No.
Oh.
No, sorry to disappoint everybody.
Oh.
I do it for the sake of family, but... In the past, you've had so many bereavements.
Yes.
That I'm glad when it's all over.
Oh, I'm sorry to hear that, Joyce.
Because it was all November and December. We lost three or four of our loved ones, you know?
That must make it really tough for you.
Very. Anyway.
Yes.
Moving on.
Psychics.
Yes. I went one day with a friend of mine. She said, oh, come on, I don't want to go on my own. Let's go to this spiritual healing something. It was a group, you know, like a little cinema thing.
Yes.
And I said, oh, I don't know. Anyway, I did go with her. And during the course of the event that she was doing, she was saying, right, I'm going to go to this part of the room now.
Yeah.
And she sort of waved to our area, you know. And it was about 10 rows up and about 6 to the left and the right. So it was, well, it was quite good. And anyway, with that, she said, somewhere just there. And we looked and we were all thinking, oh, no, it's not me.
Yeah.
And the next thing it was, she said, well, somebody just moved house. And there was this young teenager girl at the back of us.
Oh, yeah.
And she said, I can see they've had lots of fun and laughter because she's fixing this article, like a bedroom, furniture, or a chair, or something.
Some article, yes.
Got it all together,
yeah.
And she got standing up, ready to think, yes, it's all in the right place, I'll screw it together.
Yeah.
And the dog jumped off the bed and jumped on and moved it all.
The psychic is saying this.
She was telling, and this girl's going, oh, that was me! So anyway, with that, she said also, can you relate to it? So she said, yes. And her mum was with her, I think, or somebody older. And she said, and have you been down the garden yet? And she said, no, not yet. So anyway, she said, well, at the bottom of that garden, there's a big tree.
Yeah.
And if you can't see like a tree with leaves at the present time, look for the trunk, because there's two initials carved on it with a heart on it.
Oh.
And when we did see her down the shop, she said, you know, there was. There was carving on that tree at the bottom of her garden. So, you see, what can you say?
Well, what I can say is that that girl was a plant.
I don't know what she was.
She was a friend. She was a friend of the psychics.
And I thought, oh, gosh, yeah. Yes, possibly it was.
She was a friend of the psychics.
Right.
Or also, if there hadn't have been a heart on the tree, we'd have never known, would we?
You no,
have to
we
think,
wouldn't.
How many other stories that psychic said that evening that didn't come true? And maybe she got lucky with that one.
I don't know, but anyway, it was quite a bit of a whiz that night, you know.
Justin, you heard Joyce's story. What do you reckon?
I think that's a fantastic story. Again, it backs up that some people out there do have special powers, Iain.
Do the special powers, do you think that's it, Joyce?
Well, I do. I think some people definitely have something like healing or sensual,
yeah,
spiritual.
Doctors, you're thinking of Marvin Gaye and sexual healing.
But come on, Iain, how else would that psychic have known about that heart and the initials? That is so specific, and that was absolutely spot on. You couldn't make that up if you tried.
Jenny's in Milton Keynes. Morning, Jenny.
Good morning, Iain.
Tell me about your psychic experience,
please.
Well,
it was a really wonderful experience. It's happened twice, and I think, yes, there are some fake ones about.
Yes.
The two that I've speak to have been really, really true.
OK.
I go back 17 years ago.
Yes.
I was going through a very, very bad divorce with my first husband, and... my friend, she was training to be a clairvoyant, and she said to me, would you like a read? She didn't charge me anything.
Training to be a clairvoyant? How do you train to be? Surely you have the gift or not?
Yes, she did have the gift.
The gift.
She said to me, can you give me something, you know, something of yours? And she said, yes, she said, you're going to meet there's two gentlemen, she said.
Oh.
There's two gentlemen. One's got a lot of money.
Yep.
And one's a little bit older. It's as if they're going to pick you up from the gutter. She said, but you're going to choose the older one. And I said, oh, yeah. She said, it's not going to be a very, very long marriage, but it is planned for you.
Yeah.
It is planned. The spirits are planning for you. She said, I can see them holding your hands. And she said, you're going to this older gentleman. He's going to be really, really, really good. She said, you're never going to get one as good as that.
So oh.
I didn't believe her. I thought it was a load of old, you know.
Yes.
And anyway, I went to a dance. My friend said, well, as you're going to a rough do, would you like to go to the dance? And I said, oh, yes, please.
It'd be nice, wouldn't it?
Yeah. So I went to dance.
Yes.
And this gentleman, very nice, tall, elderly gentleman, came up and asked me to dance.
Oh, hello, hello.
And I said to my friend, I said, you know, I said, there's something special about that. When I said, I don't know what it is. Anyway, as time went on, he asked me to dance, he asked me out, and we were getting on very, very well together.
I bet you were, yes.
And he said, and we lived together for 15 wonderful years. I had 15 wonderful years of my life.
Yes.
And I got married. I would have been married 3 years last year. But sadly, he died in 2012.
I'm sorry to hear that.
And I missed him very, very much. And he was really, really wonderful.
You went to a reading at a carvery.
Yes, they had. Yes,
at a carvery. Where
they had special spiritual team.
In a carvery. Very,
yes.
Carvery doesn't seem. That's where they just serve lots of meat, isn't it?
Yes, and then it was a pub as well.
It doesn't sound a very spiritual place, a carvery.
It wasn't, but it was very. It was. I can't advertise, else I'd tell you where it was.
Was it a Burnie Inn?
It was a Shenley Inn. Shenley Inn.
Okay, well, it's fine. It's
and,
okay.
Anyway, I had a clairvoyant reading, and I was a bit worried. I thought, well, I wonder, you know, I know that he died, and I didn't know if anything. Anyway, there's this clairvoyant. She says to me, well, have you got something that, you know, your husband gave you? And I
yes.
said, yes, I gave him my pink ring. And do you know,
gave
without a word of a lie, I've got a pink ring which he bought me.
Wow.
And it's without a word of a lie.
Gosh. You gave that to the psychic?
Yes, just to see, and without a word of a lie, his spirit, he came right through to me. She described him to a T. She said he's slightly thin, he's got back problems and pointed toe, and he's pointing at your knee. I've never seen this woman before, and it's true. I've had 3 knee replacements and 1 hip replacement, and at the particular time, it was playing me up a little bit.
Yeah.
And
wow. And he mentioned your husband's had a manky toe.
Yes, he said, because he had a septic toe.
Septic
at one
toe! I've got their second album somewhere. Septic
yeah,
toe?
He had a septic toe, and I mean, I've never seen this one. How the hell she knew, I never knew. And I had to think about
wow.
it, because it was some time ago. And oh, yes, he did have a septic toe, and he asked me, she said he's pointing at his toe.
And so you're in a carvery, and the psychic found out about your husband's septic toe just simply by looking and holding your pink ring.
Yes, and
incredible.
It was really incredible.
Incredible.
What's next in the podcast?
Chris in Farley Hill. Enough said.
What did he do that time?
He talked about some stuff, didn't he?
I think it was about airports.
Yeah.
Airports, wasn't it? Was it about airports? Oh, you decide. Here he is.
Simply having a wonderful Christmas time. Everybody. Simply having a wonderful Christmas time.
Get a pipe up in jail. A wonderful Christmas time. Goes on, doesn't it?
Sea moon. Somebody's knocking at the door.
Is that it?
Here we go.
Christmas time.
Yo.
Oh, Merry Christmas.
Ding dong.
Ding dong.
That's a bit too fast for me, that one.
Chris, I'm glad you called in. You reminded me what we were going to do today. We're
What's
having
that?
A competition
right.
with literally no prizes.
That we don't want them.
No, we don't prizes. To see who can do the lowest sound.
The lowest?
The lowest.
As in bass, is it?
Yes.
See, when I was at Chorley, I sang in school choir.
Oh.
And, you know, all the parents were in tears. My voice broke, I couldn't do much.
Could you not do much at all?
No, but I was told to, but Mr. Roberts, he's dead now. Well, he said, just go do 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 do. People say that maybe if they're tone deaf, they can't. People can.
What?
If they're tone deaf, they can try something.
They can try, but it just sound awful.
Yeah, I know, but
yeah,
you can't say that.
Okay, so, well, no, you can't. But here we
have
are.
Have you ever listened to a trying to sing who's totally tone deaf?
Have I ever listened to a singer who's totally tone deaf?
Yeah, trying to sing.
Do you mean tone deaf or deaf deaf?
No, I mean, it can't hit a note.
No. Well, yes. Well, no.
You have to go with the flow, don't you?
So, I'm going to try and do a low note, and you see if you can do it low. And this isn't even my lowest note. I've not even warmed up yet, OK? So, here we go.
OK. Take a breath. Yeah, go on 68, give me a chance.
See if you can go lower than that, and that's not... I'm not even starting
yeah,
yet.
Yeah, but you're only a young lad.
Sorry, Chris?
I'll go... I'm 68, I'm old in...
Well, then yours should have dropped further.
That's a bit...
Right, okay, I can beat that.
No, you can't.
Do yours again, and I'll beat it.
I need to go... Hang on.
Here we go.
Do it again?
Yeah, do it again, and I'll beat it.
I'll go lower then.
I won that. Catherine Boyle, who won that?
You.
Thank you very much.
You're half a note out there.
Yeah, exactly. Chris, what do you want?
No, hang on. I'm going back to... I got a mortgage on a mason in Benin Avenue.
Oh, fantastic.
Leah's, and my daughter was up to... She's now 45.
Yeah.
And the noise then, I don't know about... The Wyman pub was there. It's still there.
Yep.
Named after a car. And the car park, you see, was full of trucks and vans. And it's all finished now.
Well, Chris, I appreciate your call. Thanks very much. 08459 455 555. It's open house today. You can call in about anything you want. Dave's in Luton. Morning, Dave.
Good morning, boss.
Dave, your band. Let's go to line two. Dennis is in Luton. Good morning, Dennis.
Good morning, Iain.
Good morning, Dennis. What can I do for you?
I heard this morning that there's going to be they're recommending or going to apply for a bypass at Buckingham.
We were talking about this, yes, a bypass for Buckingham. The councillors think it's going to be an excellent idea. What do you reckon?
Well, what about one for Luton and Dunstable?
Oh.
About time we had one, because they've been talking about it for about 55 years. And Luton and Dunstable are in a hell mess.
Oh, someone's got a little catchphrase, haven't they? Hey, someone's got a cheeky catchphrase. Why should Luton have one? How will it benefit?
Iain, you take Luton in the morning, even Dunstable,
yes?
And at the evening, even during the day, Luton is at a standstill.
Yep.
Everywhere you go, there's a standstill. There's
where?
Roadblocks.
Luton's not at a standstill.
It is.
Where?
Have you come down into Marsh Road in Leegrave.
Yeah.
Right the way through the day, it is at a total... The traffic even goes up Sundon Park Road.
I'm typing away because I got sent... Where is it? I got sent an interesting email about Luton and the Dunstable bypass. It was a... Oh, where is it? It was a conspiracy theory. And someone... Let me just see if I can find it. It would have been yesterday's show. Hang on. Record hop, court drive, shared space, performers, sports personality, Studio 1B, some news. Did you call the vinyl heads? No, I can't find it. Basically, someone's put forward the conspiracy theory, Dennis, that the Luton to Dunstable busway, it's all part of a bigger project that we don't know about. That basically, Dunstable is being prepared to be absorbed into the city of Luton.
Well, what difference is that going to make? You can't go up the busway. Well, many people try to go up the busway, but what the difference? You know, we've been talking about Luton and Dunstable bypass for the last 50 years.
Yeah.
We've got nothing. You go to Bedford, they've got five bypasses.
Yes.
Now, Luton haven't got one or Dunstable. Why? Can we ask the council? Because Luton is coming to a total gridlock. Hello? We're off again. Hell mess.
What is John, what do you want?
You just had Dennis on.
Yes,
it
is.
Luton.
Yes.
You switched him off, or you bumped him off again. Disgusting.
Who did I bump off? I'm confused now. Dennis, that's your brother.
Yes.
He'd finished his point.
No, he didn't. He wanted to speak on, but bumped him off.
What did you
disgusting.
Think?
Disgusting.
What? Is it disgusting?
It's disgusting.
What did Dennis want to say, John?
About the bypasses of Luton.
What did he want to say about the bypasses of Luton? What did he want to say, John?
What he wanted to know... No, are you going to ring up the council and find out?
No. I'm not going to ring up... No.
Who the hell mess at that BBC Three Counties Radio, isn't it?
Can we have that for a trail?
Yes, we can. Dennis, one of the regular guests on the show, and Shirley, I say guest, caller, I say caller, spoke to each other this week. This was the results.
Good morning to you. Let's get the Merry Christmas out of the way first of all.
Yes, Merry Christmas to everybody.
Righto. Now then, Iain, this lady who's been out of a house for Christmas, what about the other people? It's a company that's gone bust. What about the other people? Are they being pushed out as well? I think it's totally...
Dennis, what is wrong with your phone line? You sound like a Dalek.
Well, I'm trying to go as deep as I can.
Should we play that? Shirley, do you fancy a game of who can go the deepest?
Well, I don't think I can go as deep as Dennis.
Well, let's... Shirley, you go first.
Well, I just want to say, I do feel very, very sorry for that lady.
Oh, it's a terrible story, isn't it?
Isn't it dreadful? It's so sad. And for what she's been going through as well, it's a terrible thing.
Very, very sad.
It is. Very sad indeed.
Well, hopefully it's Christmas. Something will get sorted out, won't it? Won't it?
Well, I would like to think the council would come up with something for them.
Well, we were trying to get them on, and we did think that they were going to, but it seems they won't now.
Maybe
we've got it wrong. Maybe someone's listening now who can tell us otherwise. If anyone from Decorum Borough is listening now, 08459 455555.
Shirley, before you go, because you are going, my love, give us your deepest noise you can. Go on.
Oh, hello. Merry Christmas to everybody.
Shirley, have a lovely Christmas. I'll speak to you in 2014.
Okay.
Ta-ta, bye-bye. There we go. That was a good effort, wasn't it? Dennis?
That was delightful.
There was something vaguely 50 Shades of Grey. She was deep. She was deeper than you.
I'm an old man. What can I expect?
Here we go. I'm going to go. Catherine, you have a go.
Oh.
What? Kelly Betts, your turn.
Bomb.
You can't say that.
What did you say?
I didn't mean to say that. I was just trying to make a noise.
Right, here you go. Here's mine.
Why are you standing up?
That was the same as mine.
That was a burp.
That was a good. Dennis, see if you can beat it. Dennis? That's Dennis trying to get started first thing in the morning.
It's Christmas, for God's sake.
Isn't it just? Are you going to come down to the studio this morning?
Unfortunately, I have no transport.
How about if we sent Justin Dealey over to you?
I would be very happy to. He'll get a cup of tea if he's careful.
Really? Right, yes. Right. Dealey's on his way.
La, 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 la. It's Christmas time. La, 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 la. Christmas time. La, 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 la.
All right, OK.
Justin took this to the streets.
While we're doing that, why are we doing this in a breakfast eatery and not in the studio at Three Counties Radio?
Working from home. Multitasking.
OK, it's neither of those things, but carry on. Lots of people on Facebook talking about the picture of myself and Kelly Betts in our wonderful Christmas jumpers.
Lovely.
A lot of fun.
Where was my invite to this Christmas jumper party, by the way? Yeah?
Andrew says... This is disgusting. Andrew says, Kelly Betts, under my tree on Christmas morning. Now there's a present. Merry Christmas to you all at Three Counties.
What a dirty thing.
Get around here on Christmas Day. I'll give her a treat.
And Junaid says, love your show, Iain, but this Christmas time, la 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 la. Christmas time, la 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 la. Christmas time, la 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 la.
You're changing it. You're doing remix versions.
Yeah. Did you see that comment from Andrew, who wants you under his Christmas tree?
No.
Dirty. Anyway, Junaid says, this Christmas time song, it's so annoying, both of your voices.
Oh, thank you.
Can't wait till JVS smacks a keyboard on your heads next time you sing it. Lol.
There I think JVS texts. Secretly likes it, you know.
There are texts. Do you want to hear those?
I guess.
Iain, can you and Kelly please stop singing that Christmas song? It's making me gringe.
Gringe?
Yeah. I think that's a cross between the Grinch and cringe. I'm trying to work. I find I keep shutting my eyes and shaking my head. Love the show. The Ledge.
Is that it?
No. There's more. I with Sue turn it in with that stupid chat, but that's Nick who has hated it from the start.
La, 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 la.
I tell you what, I'm not interested in what the texters think. I'm interested in what the people, the man and indeed the woman on the Luton Omnibus thinks. And Justin, you've been out to speak to these people, haven't you?
I have. Iain, do you know what, over the last couple of weeks, since you've started singing this song, by the way, can you give me another 10 seconds just to refresh our listeners' memory of just how bad this is? Take it away, come on.
Christmas time, la 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 la. Christmas time, la 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 la. Christmas time, la 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 la. Christmas time.
Okay.
La, la, la,
okay.
La, la,
okay. La.
So, over the last couple of weeks, Iain, I am your man on the street, talking to people day in, day out. And do you know what? So many people have come up to me saying to me,
they love
this song.
They love it.
This
Where
song.
Can I buy it? Yeah. I love it.
You wanted feedback. I have got you feedback. I took the track out. Yep. I played it to people. And here's what they had to say.
Bring on the comps.
Chris, Iain Lee's Christmas anthem. What do you think?
I've got to be honest. I think it's rubbish. Sorry.
He's not going to be happy with that, is he?
I'm sorry. I'm sorry, but I've got to tell the truth. I don't like it. I think it's awful.
So what do you think about this noise?
It's very repetitive and it goes on and on and on and on.
Has it got potential?
No.
Well, I'm not very musical, but he certainly isn't.
What? What's this Muppet?
Pam, Christmas time. La 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 la. What do you think?
I think it needs a few more words.
Oh, for goodness sakes.
Yes, I think just a few
more
words.
Who's he talking to?
Like sort of maybe 50 or 60 more.
Oh, who's that, Andrew Lloyd Webber?
It's a little flat. It needs to be a bit more cheery.
Rahad, good morning. Lovely hat. How are you today?
I'm very well, thank
Rahad's going to like it. Rahad's
very well
like
indeed.
It.
I work with somebody called Iain Lee. Take a listen to this. This is his Christmas record.
Come on, Rahad.
La 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 la.
Sing it, come on.
La 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 la.
Rahad's got it.
Christmas time. La 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 la. Christmas time.
Messing around with the tune a bit.
La la la. Christmas time. La 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 la. Christmas.
Come on, get higher. Come on.
La 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 la. Christmas time. La 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 la.
You can hear him smiling. Nice one, Rahad.
That's it. So, what do you think about this song? Would you go and buy this? I'm sure you would, wouldn't you?
I could buy it. I like it.
Yeah. Good lad.
A lot going for it, isn't it?
Yeah.
I like Ryan.
Diane, you have the misfortune of listening to Iain Lee every single morning. This is his Christmas song.
Come on, Diane. Come on, Diane.
It's not very good.
Oh, Diane, who's this?
Can't really say much more than that. That it's not.
Say anything good about
Diane.
It. Come on.
No, it's terrible.
Sharon, you're laughing.
Come
you
on,
must
Sharon.
Like this.
It's dreadful. Oh. You've got to laugh. It's appalling.
Now, I'm not even listening to the rest of that. Who are these idiots? I like Rahad. Rahad was great. Rahad was brilliant, and he was freestyling a bit with the tune. I'll have a word with him.
He made it better, to be honest, but it didn't take much.
But who was Sharon and Diane and...
There was a lady there who gave us some really good feedback, actually.
Yep.
She said it needs more words.
50 or 60.
Yeah. 50 or 60 more words.
We can do that.
We can do that.
A tune?
Catherine, please.
We could do like Christmas time, la 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 la. Or we could do other things like mistletoe,
la 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 la. Reindeer, la 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 la.
Santa Claus,
la 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 la.
How many words is that?
Christmas tree, la 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 la.
Listener switching off.
La 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 la.
Catherine, let's make a point here.
Yes, please, Justin.
Now, you asked for people on the street to give their views.
Yep.
The only person who enjoyed that is somebody who won't be celebrating Christmas. Just saying.
Well, I think that it shows that our song reaches out to lots of different people.
I don't see boundaries of race, religion, creed or colour.
Just a minor point.
It's universal.
Right.
You know Johnny MK? He reckons he's got special powers. No, not like Psychic Gary. The power to fix.
Anything, especially lonely ladies with a broken heart.
He'll fix you.
Open door today if you want to turn up at the studio. You can do. You can pop in and sit in for a little bit on the show, or you can give us a call about anything you want. And John in Milton Keynes has done just that. Good morning, John.
Good morning, Iain.
John, what would you like to say?
Well, I've been told by a few people, a few close friends, that I can fix anything. And you know, I won't be able to put my mind at rest unless we can test a theory.
Okay.
You've told I can fix, repair anything. That's what they tell me.
Why do they tell you that?
I've DIY, rebuilt cars, can do landscaping, and I've been told I'm multi-talented and I can fix and repair anything.
Okay.
That's what I've been told.
How are we going to test that this morning?
Well, if anyone's got any problems that they'd like me to fix, maybe I can help them fix it, you know. whatever it, you know, if there are any lucky ladies online and might have a broken heart even, maybe I can fix that. I don't know, but fix things.
Okay, well, let's put it out there, shall we? Give us a call now, 08459 455 555. Do you need anything fixed? And particularly, if you are a lucky lady with a broken heart, was that the phrase, John?
Maybe a lucky lady with a broken heart.
If you're a lucky lady with a broken heart that needs fixing, give us a call now and you can have a chat with John. Here comes a phone call. 08459 455 555. Just to say, we don't know, for all we know, John could be a murderer. I'm not saying you are, John, but we don't know, do we?
No, you don't.
Are you sure you're not a murderer?
Absolutely, I guarantee you I'm not.
OK, because a murderer would never, ever say that. Let's see who we've got. We've got Jay. Jay, are you a lucky lady who's with a broken heart?
I'm just unlucky, I think.
I got it. It's Jay. Jay, right.
Hello, mate.
John, see if you can fix Jay's problem. Jay, give him the problem again.
Keep me with it, Jay.
Morning, mate. Were you able to give me £420 to fix my bailiff problem?
Well, I'll have to get back to you on that, Jay. You know, I'll have to get back to you.
Hang on a minute, John. You're falling at the first hurdle.
No, you see, the thing is, I have to give it some consideration. But I'm not saying I can't fix it. But it's one of these things where I need to give it some consideration as to how to fix it, how to most effectively fix it for Jay.
Can you give him any tips on how to make £400 in an hour?
Well, just do what the banks do. Just create money.
OK. Jay, thank you very much indeed. 08459 455 555. We've got John on. He claims he has a special talent. Let's put it to the test. Although, the first hurdle there, John, you kind of fell rather spectacularly, didn't you?
Well, yeah. I mean, I think Jay sort of threw a wobbly at me there, didn't he, really?
Right. OK.
Well, I'll tell you what. Anything that doesn't involve money... How's that?
OK, so okay, then now we're getting more specific. I like it. Thank you, John. So yeah. Anything that doesn't have... The filter has been installed. Any problems that don't involve money, 08459 455 555, and John in Milton Keynes will be able to fix it. We're not getting many lucky ladies with a broken heart coming on. Oh, no, hang on a second. I stand corrected. Tasha?
Yes?
Are you a lucky lady with a broken heart?
I'm a lucky lady with no broken heart. But I just want to say, Iain, I love your Christmas song.
My Christmas song? I didn't make one.
Christmas song, la 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 la.
Well,
I'm loving it.
Tasha, with the greatest of respect, there aren't many words and you've got the words wrong.
Oh, OK.
No, it's a minor criticism. Kelly, could you correct Tasha?
Christmas time, not song.
La 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 la.
Christmas time. La 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 la.
Christmas time. Your mic's off,
Catherine.
Christmas time. Christmas time. La 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 la.
She's freestyling.
La la la
la la. It all needs fixing.
La 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 la. Christmas time. La la la.
I love it. Just keep singing it every day.
Oh, Tasha, I love you, baby.
I love you.
I love you, baby.
I'm going to play that song to all my friends on the Christmas Eve. Everybody's going to listen to it. Christmas time, la 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 la. Christmas time, Santa's come to town.
Christmas time,
Santa's come to town.
I like the new lyrics.
Tasha, but you just to clarify, you're not a lucky lady with a broken heart.
No, but I've got a problem, though.
Go.
I've got a problem.
John, here we go.
My car,
hit me.
Dash, is saying... VSA for like 8 months, and it's got a triangle thing with the finger.
What's saying that? Your dashboard on your car?
Yeah, it's saying VSA.
La 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 la.
VSA. But do you know what? I said I can fix things, right? Oh. I can actually sort of sub issue that to somebody else who knows. So imagine me being like a fix-it consultant, if you know what I mean, where I can, you know, you get given a job and you can outsource it to somebody else who does know.
Yeah, but you have to be the boss to do that.
I can be your point of contact, couldn't I? So I can sort of fix it for you. Yeah.
Point of contact, la 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 la, la 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 la. Yeah.
No, I think that singing voice needs fixing as well, if you don't mind me saying.
No.
I think your one needs fixing as well, Iain.
La 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 la, Christmas time, la 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 la. There you
go. Definitely,
John, I've got to be honest,
Tasha, I think you have a beautiful voice.
Ah, thank you.
And your ability to come up with lyrics just off the cuff, it really is remarkable. I love you, Tasha.
There you go. I love you too, guys. Keep singing. Keep
Christmas
singing.
Time. La, 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 la. Thank you, Tasha. John.
See, the thing is, I feel like I've been caught out here, because if someone was to phone in to say, how do they put a shelf up, or how do they, like, dig a hole to put, like, a plant in or whatever, I could have told them.
Hang
but,
on
I mean,
a minute.
I've been... I've been tricked. I think I've been duped. I've been tricked.
No, you've come on. You phoned us up apropos nothing, saying that you have a special talent, that your friends say you can fix anything. You've had two offers of fixing things, and nothing has been sorted at all.
We've got a text.
Go on.
Martin says, can you fix my WSUS server? Has an error code of 0x800-78224. Thanks, Martin.
John, can you fix that?
Well, I'll have to consult my electronics.
Go away. Go away. Absolutely awful. What kind of charlatan is that? I can only apologise for the last 5 minutes.
On the last show... before Christmas, what we called the Christmas special, I opened the doors up of BBC Three Counties Radio. It was like Willy Wonka opening the doors to his gorgeous chocolate factory. And people from all around the world were scrabbling to get to the studio before the 9 o'clock deadline. Unfortunately, only two people actually managed to find the studio. One of them was Alex.
BBC Three Counties now. Radio.
Someone's turned up. It's Alex. Morning, Alex.
Hello, morning.
Good morning. Now, listen, who are you?
I'm a guy. I live in Leighton Buzzard.
Yeah.
I run a business in Milton Keynes. I'm a single dad, got two boys, 2 and 4.
Oh, 2 and 4?
Yes.
They must be going nuts for Christmas.
Yeah. They're just nuts generally, really.
My boys are going to be 2 and 4 in January.
Yes.
It's hard work, isn't it?
Yeah, I mean, I feel like we have a bond, really, because I hear you saying what I'm thinking most of the time.
The fighting,
there's rough and tumble, and it's all good.
My eldest did a funny thing the other day, and I have to be careful how I phrase this on the air.
Yeah.
What he does is he likes doing rhyming words.
Right.
yeah, exactly.
And examples?
He likes making words up as well. So he was talking the other day, he was going, trucking, hucking, shucking.
Yeah.
And then he did it. And of course, I'm sorry. What did you
Bad
say?
Dad.
And he did it again. And I am desperately trying not to laugh. And I don't want to draw. Yeah. He's obviously got no idea what that word is. That's
just
a word.
Encouraging.
That encourages it. But he's there and he's dropped the F bomb in the middle of the high street.
Really?
Naughty boy.
Did you have witnesses?
There were people there, but I managed to pull him away quickly before social services were called. So, son, you don't know what you're saying. You popped in the studio. Very kind of you to turn up.
I have. Do
you want to give your business a plug? What kind of stuff do you do?
I run an IT company. We specialise in telephony for businesses.
So you're rich then?
Well, no, because no one really speaks anymore.
Oh.
They text and they send emails. Oh. And so once the generation of, say, us and above have all kind of retired...
That's it.
...probably people won't use a telephone. But okay. I'm kind of riding that wave, you know, flogging that donkey.
That dead horse.
Yes, that dead horse.
You're here in BBC Three Counties Radio. Is it as glamorous and as exciting as you'd always imagined it would be?
No.
Oh.
It does look like the TV days have long gone.
So very, very true. Very, very true.
I thought there would be security.
Yep.
And I would have been probably quickly established as stalker or something like that. Just told
no
to go
frisking,
away.
No metal detectors.
I literally walked in, sat down, helped myself, and now I'm here. And
dreams
I did
can
have
come
to fight
true.
My way through the crowd.
You know. Dreams can come true. Now, listen, we can't let you go. We're playing the lowest voice game.
Yes.
So I'm going to give you my... I have to assume... This is the position I've been assuming all morning. I don't. Can you beat that? I mean, you're only a short fella, with the greatest of respect.
Oh, thanks a lot.
Get nice and close to the mic.
Thanks for reminding me.
Here we go.
That's not really a note, is it? That's more of a...
I don't know if that's loud enough.
It's loud enough. Catherine's just watching at home.
You have to kind of work your way down.
It's the face you're doing.
I'm putting every single energy.
You two are left in charge of children, aren't you?
This is the great thing about being a dad. This is the kind of stuff I do with my boys all day.
Oh, yeah. That's what life's about.
Who's got the lowest voice out of me and Alex here?
I want to say Alex.
Well, yeah, but who... Okay, you want to say it, but what's the answer?
Alex.
Oh, for goodness sakes. Alex, well done. I'll let you have that one.
Bang on.
If you want to, you can stick around and listen to how I deal with Justin Dealey.
I'd love to.
Yeah, sure you would. Justin, say hello to Alex.
Hello, Alex.
Hello, Justin.
How are you, sir? You well?
I'm very good. Another legend.
Well, I won't go too far.
Dennis and Dunstable has been irritating the heck out of my show for the last year. We thought we'd send the lads round to sort him out. Unfortunately, the lads were busy, but Justin Dealey was free. He's contractually obliged to do what I say between 6 and 9 on a weekday morning. So he went to meet Dennis, and do you know what? It was all rather lovely and special, wasn't it, Just?
It was very nice. Got a mouthful, sorry.
Now, Justin Dealey's on the line. Morning, Justin.
Hey, good morning, boss.
You all right?
Well, not really, no.
Oh, why?
Because you've sent me to Dunstable to go and meet Dennis.
Yeah.
And
yeah.
I'm outside his home, and yeah. To be quite honest with you, I'm scared.
you have every right to be. Dennis from Dunstable, regular caller. Mm. I have no idea what he looks like.
Oh, hang on a second. Somebody's walking out of their house.
Oh,
where on earth did you get those trousers from? He's got 1965 net curtains at his window. There's a CCTV camera. What on earth is that?
Is he there?
Dennis, can you come out for us?
Is he looking through the window at you?
No, he actually came out, looked at me, and has now walked back in. Dennis! Come on, Dennis! He can't walk very fast, bless him. What on earth is he wearing? He looks like something out of a Mr. Motivator fitness video. Wow. Should we have a quick chat with him now?
Yeah, go on, have a word with him. Go on.
Dennis, come to the car. Dennis, are you the real Dennis in Dunstable?
Certainly, of course I'm the real Dennis. There's only one Dennis in Dunstable, a miserable old sod like me.
Yeah, you sound scary on the phone, in the flesh, wow. Would you like to describe yourself to our listeners? Can you try and do that for us?
Yes, I'm nearly 89, I'm fat, yeah. I'm struggling, I'm walking around as though I'm drunk.
Yeah.
I live right up at the school here, I used to be a governor in there, the kids are marvellous. The parents are a damn nuisance. Yeah. They park halfway across my drive and my next-door neighbour's drive.
Dennis, describe to our listeners what you're wearing. We are going to talk to you in full after 8:45,
right.
But describe to our listeners what you're wearing today, please.
Right. Blue shirt, mm-hmm. Blue tracksuit with a stripe down the side, blue trainers, blue and white, not sweater.
Is he off to the gym or something?
Is he what, Iain?
Is he going off to the gym in that outfit?
I don't know where he's going. Are you going to go to the gym in that later on?
No, I didn't. I've not been to the gym now for about 3 years.
Right, OK.
Yeah. I got damaged, so I stopped going. Okay.
Justin, listen, can you make me a cup of tea?
Yes.
You go and get a cup of tea. We'll speak to you in about 10 minutes. Can you get a selfie with you and Dennis, please?
Yeah. And can you remind me of the point of being here again? Again, I am rather scared about going into this home.
There is literally no point apart from to scare you.
Yeah. Yeah. Oh, so somebody else is looking out the window now.
Is that Wynn?
Yeah. Oh. Do you know what? Oh, Wynn. I tell you what, Wynn. Oh, Dennis, he's punching above his weight, isn't he?
Just. Oh, dear. Oh, dear. We'll speak to them a little bit later on in the show. Doesn't he sound different in good quality? He sounds really different. Oh, I'm enjoying this today. This is fun. I move along, so I'm joy. Hello.
Hello. Oh, sorry.
Is that your phone?
Active.
Would you like to? No, you can take the phone call if you want.
No.
Would you like to introduce yourselves to the listeners?
I'm Adelaide.
Adelaide, hello.
Hello.
And you've taken up my offer of just coming in.
I have.
And saying hello.
I have.
Well, it's very nice to see you, Adelaide. Are you a local lady?
I am. I've just dropped off my children, and I just wanted to come in, take this opportunity to come in and see you.
You should have been.
And I love your song.
Have a Christmas time. La 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 la. Christmas time. La 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 la. Christmas time.
Catherine, you see, Adelaide's got taste.
Oh, I love it.
Adelaide's
I think it's fantastic. And I just want to see Catherine's face. Christmas time. La 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 la.
Okay, so
Christmas
now you're using
time.
The listeners to bully me.
Yeah, that's right.
Merry Christmas.
You can take me to a tribunal. You can't take Adelaide to a tribunal. She's a listener. We sent Justin Dealey out to meet Dennis in Dunstable.
Oh, yes.
The legend that is. He's with him now. Morning, Justin.
Morning, boss.
There is a picture of yourself and Dennis on the Facebook page.
Yes.
He looks nothing like it. For those who don't know, Dennis is the one on the left. Just in case there's any...
I'm the tall one. I'm the little short one is him, not me.
Justin, you've had a very lovely nut cut.
Yes, thank you.
Tell us what's happening with you and Dennis. Are you in the house now?
No, we're actually in the car. I've been inside the house, yep. And I got myself out rather quickly. I made an excuse and said, look, we've got to go to the car to broadcast. No, stay, stick around. I went inside. They weren't listening to your show, to be fair, Dennis and Glenn. Oh. They were actually watching Billy Joel. Well, which I think is quite nice.
They were watching Billy Joel at 8:45 in the morning.
Yeah, what were you doing that for, Dennis?
Well, because my wife had it on. I didn't know I didn't know him from Adam.
Tell your wife she should have it off.
She has, okay. Very often.
To be fair, Iain, Dennis's wife, Glyn, has been trying it on, hasn't she?
All the time.
Yeah. And, Iain, Dennis has got a photograph here. Well, we are going to take a photograph of this for our Facebook page. Describe this to Iain and why you've got this with you today, Dennis.
I was a gorgeous 21-year-old, and I've listened to Kelly Betts, and I think if she was at that age... she would have never stopped running if I'd caught her.
Kelly, I don't know if you heard that. Dennis has got a picture of him as a 21-year-old, and he's trying to think of some way he can go back in time so you can fall in love with him.
Oh, OK.
I didn't say anything about fall in love. I said chase.
Dennis, can I ask you a question? What went so horribly wrong?
You mean when I got married, don't it?
No, from that photograph to now.
Well, it's just old age. Yeah. After all, you know, I'm nearly 89, so I'm pushing this a bit now.
Yeah. I'm only joking, Dennis.
I'll tell you what, it's just that is a good thing to show to young people to say, get it now while you can, but it's not going to last.
If only the doc was here to get in that DeLorean, eh?
Dennis, can Dennis hear me?
Yes, he can.
Dennis, I just want to say thank you so much for being such a good sport over the year. And maybe we'll speak to you again in 2015.
I'm still here, yes.
OK, you can take a year off if you want.
No, I'll tell you what. I just want to say to you, you've done a marvellous job this year. I'm thrilled to bits with it, and I hope you have a very happy Christmas. With your two boys, they'll drive you up the wall like my three great-grandsons are doing now.
How old are your great-grandsons?
The eldest is about 6.
Oh, mate. Are they coming? Are you going to be seeing them over Christmas?
We've seen two of them already.
Yep.
2.5 walked into the kitchen and switched the washing machine on that my wife can't work.
Yeah, they know how to do all of that stuff. Dennis,
so I'm just waiting to see the other two.
Dennis, you've been a really good sport. I appreciate your time and all of your calls. Have a lovely Christmas, won't you?
And the same to you.
Merry
and
all your Dennis. Listeners. Merry Christmas.
Bye-bye.
This show could not be done without the listeners. We get so many phone calls. We've had so many phone calls this year. And as a big thank you to all the listeners this year, we have thought... Well, Kelly Betts has done this, and thank you, Kelly. Catherine has helped, but Kelly is the brains behind this. We have put together all of the best bits from the listeners over the last 12 months, haven't we, Kelly?
We have.
So, listeners, this is a thank you from us to you.
We're going on.
Thank you. Thank you.
Oh dear.
Excuse me.
Oh, sorry.
Excuse me.
oh dear, I've done it now.
There's a cough. What do you think? What do you say?
Sorry, I'm struggling a bit this morning.
It's a bit throaty. There we go. That's the best bits from all of the listeners this year. Thank you very much.
It was a joy to clip.
Well, I think it's been a lovely year. And I'd like to say thank you to all of you for really, really making it special for me, personally, as just someone who made an occasional appearance on the show. The end of the podcast. Iain?
Thank you.
Catherine?
Merry Christmas.
It's Christmas time. La, 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 la.
It's Christmas time.
Merry Crimbo. Keep believing.
Thanks for listening to this free download from BBC Three Counties Radio, your local radio station for beds, hearts and bucks on FM, AM, digital radio and online at bbc.co.uk/threecounties.